We're here at the Ferrari Museum in Modena, which is clearly the sexiest place to be. And we're going to go and take a look inside, have a look at some cars, get a little bit of a guided tour, and we'll let you know what's going on in the world of Ferraris, not just the mechanical side, but the chassis, the colors, the Formula One wins. It's all inside.
The museum was opened the year after Enzo Ferrari's death. That was 1990. Enzo Ferrari died in 1988 at the age of 90. Now, the museum was opened by the town of Maranello because Enzo Ferrari was always looking ahead, always looking for the next race, the next win, and the next car. And so he was not really involved in what was already produced and the victories he had already achieved in the past. So he didn't keep any car from his production, but he was very innovative in the sense that he kept in his archive all the original designs of every single component of each model that was produced in Ferrari since 1947. Now we are here closer to the very first car, 125S, which was the first car produced here in Maranello bearing the Ferrari trademark, which means produced in Maranello. Every Ferrari car gets out of the Ferrari factory just 500 meters from the museum. Now this car is indeed a replica, because in 1947 they produced only three cars and they went all destroyed during the history. And in 1987 Ferrari decided to have the car produced again by the factory based on the original designs which I spoke to you about before. And so this is a car which is working, which is used in several events, and we have here a display at the museum to tell visitors about the start of the legend and the myth of Ferrari. This car is a 12-cylinder car. 12-cylinder is by far the Ferrari engine by definition. It's an engine by which von Karajan, the director, said it has a sound that no director will ever be able to reproduce. The sound of the engine is something which reinforces the emotion of driving a Ferrari. We always say we don't sell cars, we sell dreams. And the dream is given also by the emotion of the design, the sound, and the performance of the car, of course. So we speak about the technology, we speak about made in Italy, we speak about legendary men who drove the Ferraris throughout the world in all the competitions which have been part of our history. Now, as you can see, this car is a sport car. Formula One did not exist even at the time. Formula One started in 1950, and Scuderia Ferrari is the only team who has always attended at each single championship of the Formula One races. This car was supposed to race indeed in all the other legendary competition of the time, which means the Mille Miglia, the Targa Florio, Le Mans, Tour de France, and so on. Now this car has two seats because the races were pretty long and the drivers were supposed to exchange during the race, and it won indeed its second race at Le Terme di Caracalla in Rome, driven by Alberto Ascari. Now, the design in Ferrari is something very peculiar because it has always been linked to functionality. It is a very long story to tell, but indeed, since the very beginning, since the very start, Ferrari was most concentrated on the mechanical part. He came from the engine and then all the transmission and all the mechanical components of the car. But the style, the design, the chassis was then realized by different chassis makers such as Pininfarina, Boano, Zagato, all these producers of the time. In those years, the design of the car was very much linked to the mechanical interiors of the car. So the shapes which we see sometimes are due to the fact that the chassis was to cover special features of the car, such as batteries or tanks or things like this. And the aerodynamic did not exist yet, so there was just a sense of how the car could be more effective in being speed, but not really being the result of aerodynamic studies in the wind tunnels like we do now. Then later on, in the 60s, early 60s, the first wind features appeared in the cars. We have spoilers and several wings then being added to reinforce the performance of the car. And this is how we come then in the most modern Formula One cars, where all the chassis, the bodies are produced in accordance with the FIA rules that are there to ensure also the safety for the drivers. As you can see, the very first car is a red car. Now, the history of the red being associated with Ferrari is completely different from a brand decision. In the early 20th century, when the competition started, the FIA of that time had given a rule that each constructor was to be recognized by national colors, which means that all the French cars, for instance, were blue, the British were green, the German were white, and the Italian cars were all red. So this means that much earlier than the first Ferrari car was produced, the Fiat cars, Maseratis, Lancia, Alfa Romeos, when competing in international competitions, they were all red. This is why the first car that Enzo Ferrari produced in 1947 had to be red, because it was supposed to race in international competitions. So then, during in the 60s, when the costs for the technological innovations and developments went higher and higher, the constructors went looking for sponsors, which is a very nice word, and the sponsors asked to gain more visibilities on deliveries of the car, and so at the end the FIA had to give freedom to the constructors to change their colors, but Enzo Ferrari decided to always stay red when competing. So in the competitions, meaning Formula One, but all even the others, when officially racing, the Scuderia Ferrari cars have always been red. And that provided the brand with this very strong link with by which when you see a red car racing, you think it's a Ferrari car. Now, all the Ferrari cars are produced in Maranello, here in the factory. The factory has several plants. We entirely produce the engines from the foundry to the mechanical workshop, where we finish the parts, the rough parts coming from the foundry, to the assembly lines of the engines. We produce currently both 8-cylinder and 12-cylinder engines. For the chassis, the production starts in Modena, where Ferrari owns a plant, which is called the Carrozzeria Scaglietti, where they assemble the body in white. The bodies come here to the paint shop in Maranello, and from the paint shop they go to the assembly lines of the cars, where the car gets finished and ready for the delivery to the client.